Hi everyone! No matter if you're recording a video or reading a book, it is super important to have a good lighting. And I'm talking about this because recently I moved to a new room and, well, currently this is my only light. As you can see, it's not that bright. So that's why for this video I've bought some LED strips and we are going to make some super bright DIY LED panels. So let's get started! Alright, so here's my first pull, cold white SMD5630 5 m strip. It is rated at 19 watts and 1550 lumens per meter, which in terms of brightness is comparable to a 100 watts light bulb. Pretty efficient if you ask me. Those LEDs run on 12 volts, so we will need a power supply or simply a freeze battery to power them on. But the problem with those strips is that they heat up quite significantly. And if we don't dispose of that heat, the LEDs will quickly cease to work. So I searched my garage for some metal scraps and I found a big steel sheet from which I cut this piece. Now, if we stick the strip to the steel, it will help to remove the excess heat and by doing so it will allow the LEDs to stay cooler. However, we can't just stick some LED strips on a metal piece and call it a day. We also need a solid housing. So I opened Fusion 360 and I quickly designed this case, which will protect the panel and also could be easily mounted in various configurations. The case itself is quite big, but luckily I managed to fit it on my 3D printer bed. And to print it I used white PTG, because it is resistant to high temperatures and also should reflect most of the emitted light. Next, I drilled some holes in the metal piece, so that later I could easily screw it to the housing. And after getting that done, I simply cut 9 equal strips, removed the adhesive backing and stuck them to the metal plate. Now, the last thing we have to do is to connect power wires. To do this, first I applied solder to all the positive and negative pads. Later, I took some wires and soldered them to the first and the last strip in such a way that the wires stick out of the back. I connected them to a long power wire with a switch for the ease of turning it on and off. And now, as you can see, both top and bottom strips emit bright light, exactly as they should. Now, to make all the strips glow, we just need to power them in series, just like on this diagram. But soldering all those wires turned out to be a quite time-consuming task. So let's just jump to the moment when the future me got it all working.
3 days later.
Right, so now everything is connected and just look how immensely bright it is. One night I even tested the panel outside and, well, my cat seems to quite like it. Finally, we can measure how much current our panel consumes. My drone charger shows that it's about 2 amps at 12 volts, which gives us roughly 25 watts total. Pretty good for such a bright panel. Another important thing we need to measure is the working temperature. At the beginning it had a room temperature of about 26 degrees Celsius. Next I left it on for 10 minutes and after that I measured the temperature again. It then showed 44 degrees on the steel plate, which means that the LEDs effectively transfer heat to the steel. It's important to mention that LEDs can work at temperatures up to 85 degrees, which means that the metal plate will definitely increase their longevity. Now we can also see how much power it consumed. With my 5 amp hours battery, it could provide light for more than 2 hours, which is pretty impressive. So overall, I really like how this panel turned out, and from now on, I will definitely use it to make my videos brighter. In fact, I like it so much that I decided to make another one, but this time a little bit bigger. But before that, I would like to talk about today's sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay is a company that specializes in making high-quality PCBs, as well as CNC machining and 3D printing. Recently, they reached out to me with a sponsorship offer, and I was very glad to accept it. On their website, you can order all sorts of amazing stuff. If you, for example, would like to get super detailed parts, you can try their SLA 3D printing service. If you need something more durable, why not try their CNC milling offer? And I'm not even talking about the variety of PCBs that you can get on their website. Because there's basically everything. You can get standard, advanced, or even flexible PCBs. And those are really cool. I myself will definitely use PCBWay services in the near future to create all sorts of projects from open source VSC to CNC machine gears. So go check out their website and thanks again PCBWay for sponsoring this video. Now back to the LEDs. So here is the case of our first panel. And now here is the new one. As you can see, it is, well, definitely bigger. And that's because it is meant to be a ceiling panel with a lot more LED strips. But the question you may ask right now is, how can this even be printed? Well, it can't. And that's why I separated the frame into 8 smaller pieces that can be printed and later merged together. After printing, I sanded all the parts to prepare them for painting. But before that, I had to assemble the whole frame by using M3 screws and nuts. Later, I used some white spray paint to give it a nice finished look. For this panel, I had to find a much bigger steel sheet in which I also drilled mounting holes. Next, I placed the steel square inside the frame and I fixed it with more screws. Now for this panel, I am going to use 3 LED strips with different color temperatures: cold, neutral, and warm white. By combining them, I will be able to easily change moods from colder tones for work to a more warm light for relaxation. And I also decided that there is enough space on this panel to make it appropriate for gaming, by of course adding additional RGB strips on the sides. Next, the process of sticking the strips is basically the same as in the first one, except there is a different layout as depicted by this diagram. However, soldering wires was different for RGB strips as I needed to make 4 connections for red, green, blue and ground instead of just positive and negative for white lights. The 3 LED strips share one negative wire, but they all have their own positive one, so that they can be independently switched on and off. Overall, there are 9 sections, each containing 3 different white strips and 10 RGB strips on the sides. And now, if we measure the power draw, each white color consumes about 6 amps, which at full power would give us 18 amps total. The RGB strips use much less power, about 0.3 amps for each of the primary colors and about 0.9 amps for white, which is a combination of red, blue and green, so it makes sense. At this point, I should start mounting the panel to the ceiling, but I just couldn't resist taking it outside and comparing the brightness to the smaller panel. And as you can see, the difference is quite substantial. And also, RGB lights look kind of funny in the dark. Right, but that party was running on battery, and now we need a solid, continuous power. And that's why I unmounted this 20 amps power supply from my old 3D printer. Additionally, I designed this special cover with switches and access to the inbuilt voltage potentiometer. Thanks to this, I will be able to easily switch between different white tones and also control the brightness level with the potentiometer. That is a very easy solution, but it should work well enough. Next, I mounted the panel to the ceiling. Mounted the power unit to the wall. and secured all the wires. However, keep in mind that the wires should be pretty thick, because otherwise you will experience significant voltage drops and hence less light. And now here is a little demonstration of how well it works. And even after a long time at full power, the temperatures are not that high. So I think that overall this panel performs quite well. So guys, that's basically all for this video. Thanks to this huge panel, my room is now very bright, and if I ever needed even more light for work or making my videos, I can always use the help of this guy right here. And if you want to make those panels by yourself, just go down to the description and there should be everything you need. So thank you guys for watching, thanks PCBWay for sponsoring my content, and see you all in the next video. Bye!